And God said, Behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed. To you it shall be for food. Genesis 1:29. Man did eat angels' food. He sent them meat to the full. Psalm 78:25. Everyday Manna with Lisa.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Everyday Manna. On today's program, we're going to be making chicken with a mushroom sauce. We're going to be making parsley, new red potatoes, and we're going to be making cheesecake Napoleon pizzelles. And they're so easy and so good, and you're going to love these recipes today. We're going to get started on our chicken first. Now, I've got the oven preheating to 375 degrees. That is for our chicken. I've got some celery and some onions that we need to chop. We're going to preheat a skillet. We're going to start actually with our sauce. We're going to get the sauce ready and then pour that over the chicken. So preheat a skillet on medium to medium high heat. You want to saute your vegetables. We're going to add some butter. We're going to add about half of a stick of butter and be letting that melt while we chop. Let's let that go. Add just a little bit, I'd say about a tablespoon or so of olive oil with that. That just raises the heating temperature of the butter. Butter by itself sometimes will burn. So if you add a little bit of oil to it, you can cook at a higher temperature. I've got about four stalks of celery today because they looked a little bit on the small side, and I love celery. You can add as much or as little of this as you want. I leave the leaves on my celery. I did wash it, but I leave the leaves on because I think they add so much flavor to the celery, and a lot of people just discard that, but truthfully, there is a lot of flavor in there. So you just want to kind of dice up the celery and the leaves, if your celery has leaves on it, to about, I'd say, quarter inch dice. You want it fairly fine. You don't want to mince it too small, but you want it to be a little bit on the small side. I love celery. I love it cooked. I love it raw. I love it steamed. I love it with peanut butter in the middle of it. I just absolutely love this. Now, at home, when I make this dish, many times I will cook in this part of the recipe, this stage of it, I cook a lot of celery and onion together in the butter and oil, and then I just eat the celery and the onion without the chicken and all the rest of it. We've got, like I said, about four stalks of celery there. We've got one good size onion. You want around a cup of each. You want about a cup of onion diced and about a cup of celery diced. This recipe, I've been doing it for years. I'd say 20 years, I'd say, or more. It's very easy. It uses, you know, most ingredients that we would have on hand. You might possibly have to add the one ingredient. You might have to just add that to your grocery list one day. You could substitute. We're going to be using today, we're going to use a golden mushroom soup. Now, many people cook with the cream of mushroom soup, but right beside the cream of mushroom soup is a product called golden mushroom soup. And it adds such a rich flavor to the dish that it just is so yummy. I love it in this particular dish. You could add some extra sliced mushrooms if you wanted. I'm not a real big fan of mushrooms, so I don't. But by all means, if you wanted to add some sliced button mushrooms or, you know, shiitakes or portobellos or whatever you wanted, by all means, you could do that. Our butter is melting. Our skillet is nice and hot. So let's add the onion. Be careful when you add to that. It is very, very hot. The onion and the celery to our dish. We're going to add a little bit. Let's just stir those around a little bit. We're going to add salt and pepper. I found a new salt mill that I've never used, so we're going to try it out together on today's program. It uses sea salt, which I love, and some fresh ground pepper. I'm a big fresh ground pepper user. I don't use the pre-ground stuff that you buy in the cans at the store. I just think it has no flavor whatsoever. This particular blend of peppercorns is a variety. It's a melange of peppercorns. It has the different red and pink and green together, but you could just use black. It really wouldn't matter on that. Now we're just going to let those saute until they're soft. We're going to get started on our potatoes. Let's just put that over here. Now I love little red new potatoes that you get in the grocery store. That's my favorite potato. Just absolutely love them. The little small, get the small ones today. And these, actually, I'm just going to cut in half. If they were a little bit smaller, I would leave them whole, but they're not. They're a little bit on the bigger side, so I'm just going to cut them in half. I've got some water simmering on the stove, and we're just simply going to boil these potatoes until they're tender, and then we're going to add some parsley and butter and all of the good stuff to them. So I'm just going to cut them in half, and then I'm going to add them to my water gently. Don't want to get burned. And just going to let these simmer. You don't want them to be mushy. Now, if I were making mashed potatoes, which you by all means could do with this recipe, it would be delicious with it. I would let these go a little bit further to where they're really, really, really soft. But I want them to be soft, but I still want them to have just a little bit of a firmness to them. Not too much. So you want to just kind of let them go. I'd say about 15 minutes would be plenty enough there. I'm going to put that on till it comes back up to a boil, and then I'll turn it back down. Let's check our celery and onion. This dish is so easy to make. It is one of those things, if you wanted to, you know, I'm a big crock pot user because I'm busy, and a lot of times when I get home of an evening, I don't have time to fix a good meal. So you could absolutely do this in the crock pot. You wouldn't have to saute it, just add the ingredients for the sauce together, put your chicken in the bottom of your crock pot, pour this over it, put it on low, let it simmer all day long, and it would be just as delicious. But we're just gonna do the oven version today. We wanna saute these till they're just a little bit soft. Tell you what, we're gonna go to a break, and while these are sauteing, I'm just gonna gather up a few more ingredients. And when I come back, we're going to finish this sauce, we're going to get the chicken in the oven, and we're going to start on the Napoleons. I'll be right back with you in just a minute. Hey, and welcome back. We're going to finish up our sauce. We've got our onions and celery sauteing in some butter and olive oil. We are going to add 1 can of golden mushroom soup. Now, don't make the mistake of getting the cream of mushroom. You want the golden mushroom soup. It adds the color, and it has an entirely different flavor than the cream of mushroom soup. I personally prefer it. It's just got a much richer, deeper flavor than the other. I'm gonna add just a little bit of chicken broth to the can. You know how we try to get all that last little bit of flavor out of there. Stir that up. Add that to our sauce. And let's stir that around, see where we are. I believe I need a whisk. Let me grab a whisk here real quick. And we've got our chicken breasts. Now today I'm using the boneless, skinless chicken breasts. You could use the bone-in breasts if you wanted to. That would be perfectly fine. Let's turn that back up a little bit. And your sauce is done. Now you could add a little bit of, like I said, you could slice some mushrooms if you wanted to and add to that. I'm not a real big mushroom person, so I don't choose to do that. But if you love mushrooms, by all means, add it to the sauce. We've got our potatoes simmering. I've got 6 boneless, skinless chicken breasts, and I'm going to season those up with a little bit of salt. Don't want to use too much because remember your chicken, the soup, which is bubbling away over there, has got a lot of sodium in it, and I want to add some freshly ground pepper to season up your chicken breast. Our oven is preheated to 375 degrees. The sauce is done. Doesn't that look yummy? And then just take your sauce and pour it over the chicken. Get all of that good yummy sauce out of there. Cover your chicken breasts, make sure they're covered. Then top this with a little bit of aluminum foil and into the oven it's gonna go. It's gonna bake at 375 for about 30 minutes or so. At about 20 minutes, we'll take the foil off and we will just, you know, let that get good and juicy and brown and just so very good. Now, we're gonna get started on the Napoleons. If you've never seen these in the store, the grocery stores carry them. They're so good, they come in different flavors. They're called pizzelles, and they're just little, it's an Italian cookie. They come with different little designs on them. They're very yummy. They also come in different flavors. Now for today, I'm just using the regular vanilla flavor, but they come in an anise flavor, which is a licorice flavor. They come in chocolate, they come in lemon, they come in all kinds of flavors. I'm just using the regular vanilla today. I've got one box of cheesecake flavored pudding, the pudding that we all use and know and love, the cheesecake flavor, and I've got 3/4 of a cup of milk. And we're just gonna mix that together. Just very quickly, we're gonna mix our pudding together. You could, this is one of those recipes that you could make 1,000 different ways. You could use chocolate pudding, you could use lemon pudding and make a lemon sauce to go over it. I'm just gonna use the cheesecake flavored today. You could use regular vanilla if you wanted to. And then we're gonna just add some beautiful strawberries and drizzle it with chocolate, and it's gonna be so good. You just wanna mix that together. Just 3/4 of a cup of milk and one package of your pudding mix. Now, we've got some beautiful strawberries. When strawberries come into season, and when they smell particularly good, I use them so many different ways. I love strawberries. And this particular day, the berries just looked so yummy. So I wash them in the container. I'm just gonna slice up 3 or 4 here. You might wanna keep a top or two to decorate your Napoleon with. Now, Napoleon desserts, what that means is it's like a stacked dessert. And that's what this is going to be today. We're gonna make a stacked dessert. It's just, it's high. It's got different layers of the pizzelle and the pudding and all that in there. And I think that's probably gonna be enough because we're only gonna make one real quick like. So we've just sliced up some beautiful strawberries and they smell so good. I just love them, love them, love them, love them. Now, we are gonna do, on the stove, I have a pot. Let me move this skillet out of the way here. I've got a pan with some dark chocolate, and I'm actually gonna move it over here to me so it's a little easier. With some dark chocolate. You know, nowadays you can get really good chocolate in the different flavors, and I've just got the plain chocolate chips that you buy in the store, and I'm just melting the chocolate with just a little bit of milk on my stove. You could do this in the microwave if you wanted to. You could do it over a double boiler if you wanted to, however you want to do it. It's melting beautifully here. We just want to melt. I've got about, I'd say, 1/2 cup of the chocolate chips that we just put in here with a little milk, and we're just kind of melting those through. I mean, how good is chocolate and strawberries together? It's just absolutely yummy. One of my favorite things is chocolate and strawberries together. And everything's better with chocolate on it. I'm going to show you a quick way to... Everybody likes to do the pretty desserts, the pretty piping on desserts. I love to do that, but I don't like to clean the bags. So what I do is use a disposable, little disposable. Ziploc baggie, and just use your little piping tips. You don't have to do this, it just makes it look prettier. You could just spoon it, but I want it to look pretty. Cut off the very tip end. Put your little piece down in there to where the hole is. Add your tip on there and then screw that on here. You've got an instant little pastry bag that you can throw away. You don't have to fool with cleaning. We're gonna put our pudding in this bag. Over the break, all I'm gonna do is just place this pudding in the bag, and then we're gonna come back and we're gonna assemble our Napoleons. I'll be right back with you in just a minute. Hey, and welcome back. Now we're going to assemble our Napoleons. And we've got some dark chocolate that we melted, and I just put in this little baggie. This is a wonderful way to do piping without having to clean bags. I tried that, and I'm like, I'm not cleaning those little bags. Put your chocolate in a baggie, cut off the tiniest little piece on the end, and get you a pretty plate. And you just want to kind of make it really pretty, so we're just going to pipe on a little design there. We're going to place one of our little cookies. These are just the vanilla cookies, remember. And we're going to put our cheesecake pudding in a bag, and we're just going to make some little small pretty little rosettes because we want it to be pretty. Just pipe on. You can use any kind of tip you want. I just chose the pretty little star tip. Place a few little strawberries and make sure that your strawberries peek out over the edges, oops, because you want them to, you know, you want to see the strawberries. Remember, this is a layered dessert, but we want to see the strawberries. More chocolate. Just place you a little bit of chocolate on there. However design that you want. Put another cookie, another layer of chocolate. I mean, you just can't have too much chocolate. I don't think. Some more pudding. Just however you want to do it, whatever design you want. And some more strawberries. You could use raspberries. You could use blueberries. You could use bananas. You could do this very same thing with bananas. And banana pudding and bananas, sliced bananas in the middle. Place one more cookie on top. And then just decoratively put you some chocolate on the top, however you want. Oops, here we go. And then place a couple more strawberries on top. And you could put a whole strawberry if you wanted, just so that it would be really, really pretty. And that is a stacked Napoleon with a cheesecake pudding in it, and it is so incredibly good. Okay, and now we need to finish up our potatoes and our chicken. And we've got on the stove, I have a small saucepan with about half of a stick of butter just melting in there, and it's just looking so good. We're gonna add just a little tiny bit of salt to that. And we're gonna add some freshly ground pepper to our butter that is melting. We have cooked our potatoes and we've drained them, and they're just right here waiting on their sauce. It just looks yummy. I have some fresh flat leaf Italian parsley here that I'm going to mince up. You could use the curly leaf parsley if you wanted to. I really do prefer the flat leaf parsley flavor, but you know, sometimes I can't find it. And so, you know, you can use the curly leaf if you need to. Just chop it up. You want it to be kind of fine. mince it up pretty good. I love little red potatoes, don't you? You can do them any way. They're good roasted, they're good boiled, they're good mashed, they're good fried. They're good in just any different combination of ways that you can cook. That's just probably, to me, my favorite potato. The others, I love all potatoes, but the little red potatoes, seemingly to me, are just a little, have a little more flavor. I love the new Yukon Golds that you can get in the grocery stores now, and you could substitute those. You could substitute regular white baking potatoes if you wanted to. We're chopping our parsley here. Our chicken is in the oven, and it smells so good. I think that's about good. If you just run your knife, have you ever done this before? Some people just put your knife on your board, hold it down with one hand, and then with your shoulder and your other arm, just move it back and forth, and it will mince your herbs for you really, really fine. They sell little gadgets to do this, but I'm like, why would I buy a gadget to do something that my knife will do? So we want to add our parsley to our butter mixture. Let me grab a spoon here. Cool. And we're just going to let that incorporate. Then we're going to pour that over our potatoes, and they're going to be so good. Let's get our chicken out of the oven. Now, this is just a chicken in a mushroom sauce. Remember, we started. Oh, look at it bubbling away. Let's go ahead and turn our oven off. We removed our foil after the first 15 minutes or so. And we just, you know, because you want to kind of let the top brown up a little bit. And we've just got our chicken. We started with some celery and some onions, and then we sauteed that, and then we added a can of golden mushroom soup and just a little bit of chicken broth, about a can full of just chicken broth that you buy in the store. And we just put that, sauteed that all together, added the soup and the chicken broth, poured that over our chicken breasts, and then we covered it with foil, put it in the oven for under about 350, 375 for about 25 minutes or so. Depends on the thickness of your chicken breasts. If you use little tenders, it cooks much quicker. If you use the bone-in chicken breasts, you'll need to cover it with foil and cook it for, I would say, a good 40 minutes covered, and then take the foil off and let it go about another 15 minutes for the bone-in chicken breast. But if you've got the boneless like I do, 10 minutes without the foil, 20 minutes with foil, and then 10 minutes without the foil is plenty enough time. Makes its own gravy, makes its own sauce, and it's absolutely delicious. It's great over mashed potatoes. You absolutely could cook this dish and make mashed potatoes to go alongside it if you wanted to. So plate it up, put one chicken breast on here, and I'll tell you what we're going to do. Let's make it very, very pretty. Let's take our chicken breast. It's going to be hot, so be careful. And let me grab some tongs. And don't have any tongs in here, so we will grab a fork. Hold on just a minute. And we're going to cut our chicken breast. We're going to fan it out. Just cut it into pieces. Look how moist and delicious this looks. And we will spoon some of that gravy over top of this. So let's get this on our plate. Put that on your plate. Your moist, delicious chicken. And let's put a little bit of that gravy on there. We certainly don't want to leave out the best part now, do we? And pour some of that gravy over top of your chicken. Then you want to take your butter mixture. Pour that over your potatoes, and then add a couple of potatoes, they're very hot, to our plate, and add a little bit of parsley. And there you go. There is your chicken with mushroom sauce with parsleyed red potatoes. Enjoy.
If you enjoyed this episode of Everyday Manna and would like a copy of today's recipes, please write Living Faith Television, CO Everyday Manna, P.O. Box 1867, Abingdon, Virginia, 24212, or visit our website at www.livingfaithtv.com. Please be sure to include the program number found on the bottom of the screen in your letter so we will know which recipes you would like. Thanks for watching, and join us again for the next episode of Everyday Manna.